Here are the top 5 writing AI apps in 2023. You're gonna wanna stick around to the end to figure out which one you actually think is best. Number 1, Notion AI. So I've been using this guy in the background, you know, just trying to figure some things out. And I tell you what, it is dope. There's nothing cooler than going into Notion and being like, hey, you know what? I like this text. Let me select this text. Help me write a 1,000 word YouTube script based on the top 5 AI writing tools.
Oh my God.
It's doing the thing in my Notion, which is the best note-taking app on the market. And then I can wait for it to finish. Bada bing, bada boom, replace the text. And the next thing you know, I have a script based off 5 bullet points and me telling it to make one. Now, this is more like a short outline, but you know what? For me, this is more than enough because I barely script my videos as it is. Notion has amazing database functionality, is one of the most popular apps on the market. No question, this is one of the better ones on the market. Number 2, we got Craft. Now, Craft has a assistant that goes along with it, so you can kind of see how it works. In their example video, they go hard. They go really hard in showing how it works. Check for grammar and spelling. Check for everything. Like, this is giving me a heart attack at how fast they're going. They're saying translating to Japanese. They're saying, okay, I'm uncomfortable with the speed at which you're going in this video. Please stop. Regardless, it is the first AI assistant on a mobile writing tool. So this is not available on Notion on the go, but it is available on Craft, and that is insane. This is the kind of stuff we have to think about. Is this the best one on the go? Correct, it is. So we gotta consider that when considering the best tools. Now, OpenAI for Coda has just come out. You'll see right here, you can enter prompts and it will come right out, as well as you can add a prompt for images within Coda. That's right, this is the thing. This is the differentiator for Coda. All of these can do basically what ChatGPT is doing, let's be real. But what you don't get on a lot of these other apps is the DALL-E images, which is insane. So you can, this is a really cool astronaut in the ocean. Just getting no astronaut in on a dragon flying over the moon. Honestly, if this is in real life, this would be amazing. I love sci-fi. But that's the unique value prop that Coda brings to the table for this. Not only text, but also DALL-E images. And all you need to do is connect OpenAI to your account to make it happen. Now, using Taskade AI is really simple as well. I had an entire video on this before, but it's a lot simpler of prompts. You have a couple and that's it. You kind of see that this was all written with ChatGPT and bullet points, but essentially what you get is just slash AI. You get expand, rewrite, summarize, and ask. And in some ways, this is kind of enough because it's like, what are the 5 best ways to use ChatGPT? Ask. And it'll spit it out in a second, and that's pretty great. Now, if I say, what are the 5 best ways, and do slash ask, it'll be a little bit more clear, and it'll give me 5 ways. I do like that this is a little bit shorter and to the point. That has its own competitive advantage. Other ones start with more content, others start with less. And for those of you that are looking for the short form of it, this is pretty good. But it does give you expansion if you do slash AI. Or slash, I guess, expand would be more accurate. And this is really cool. Like, this is just so cool. It keeps sub-indenting every time you make a new query. Now, you might be saying, what is even the point of using this last one, which is ChatGPT? Well, it might surprise you, actually it shouldn't, that this is the best option out of all of them. Because for one, I can just type OpenAI in, or ChatGPT, sorry, and it'll prompt right now to come in here and do this. The one caveat I will say is that ChatGPT seems to be prioritizing the applications that have it integrated within it so that that never bugs out. But when someone's using it on the public platform, it is bugging out more often than not in comparison. Like if I type, I want a script on the 5 best AI writing tools, make it 2,000 words or 1,500 words, it might give me the best writing. It might give me the best answer because it doesn't have to do the fetching and the back and forth of the API connection. However, the problem is that they aren't able to handle what's coming into it right now. I mean, this is amazing. It's gonna be probably the longest and most detailed answer, but the problem is you're not able to use this as frequently as Notion AI, because for some reason they're making sure that Notion AI users are getting it no matter what. But the front end users are kind of seeming, from what I can tell, to have more of the getting kicked out, getting errors. I don't really get errors while I'm using Notion AI, which is very interesting to me. This also provides you with the options to change it into bullet points. Really, really beautiful written text in my opinion, and it's changed the way that I've been working, honestly. But it's all based on what you need and what you want. You can, in theory, use ChatGPT for an infinite number of queries based on information that's all around you. Just like you could look at a million YouTube videos, but you're probably gonna wanna watch this one on how to improve your productivity even more.